Hello friends, welcome to GEM Academy. Now we are going to see some important case studies and questions in BFM. In a letter of credit, which of the following is primarily liable? Which bank is primarily liable? Issuing bank, confirming bank, reimbursing bank, issuing bank and advising bank. Our option is issuing bank. Issuing bank is liable for the LC. Firstly, it is issuing bank. If issuing bank fails, then it will be the responsibility of the confirming bank. Issuing bank is LC issuing bank. Next one, a report about a death of non-resident is received who has maintained NRO account with nomination which is not correct. A balance in the account will be transferred to NRO account of the nominee if he is also a non-resident. Balance in the account will be transferred to normal account of the nominee if he is a resident. Balance in the account will be sent abroad on the request of the nominee. None of the above. Our option is C. In NRI account, credit only the credit is restricted, but the debit is not restricted. It is the normal procedure of the SB account. Normal procedure of the SB account will also be applicable for the NRI account since the account is debited on the death of the NRI. A balance in the account will be transferred to NRO account of the nominee if he is also a non-resident. For NRI account, credit is restricted. So, from NRI account to NRI account, no restriction. So, this is allowed. Balance in the account will be transferred to normal account of the nominee if he is a resident. If the person is a resident, then there is no restriction in the credit. So, it can be transferred to a resident account. But this is wrong. Balance in the account will be sent abroad on the request of the nominee. On the request of the nominee, we should not send the amount. We have to hand over the amount to the nominee. So that is the wrong option. And next one. As per FEMA Act 1999, which of the following is not included in the term foreign exchange? Deposit in foreign currency, balance payable in foreign currency, demand drafts, traveler's checks payable in a foreign currency, demand drafts, traveler's checks drawn in India and payable in a home currency. Our option is D. Demand drafts, traveler's checks drawn in India, it is drawn in India and is payable in home currency. It's drawn in India and also it's in home currency. So it doesn't come under FEMA Act. Next one, a bank branch has sanctioned a term loan of 10 lakh for a period of 7 years at an interest rate of 3% plus base rate of bank. Funding is done from a deposit of 3 years at 7% interest. There is no restriction on prepayment of loan and withdrawal of deposit of customer. The transaction is exposed to what type of risk? Our option is embedded option risk. Embedded option risk is for prepayment of loan and withdrawal of deposit for customer. So, embedded option risk is the correct answer. Here it is given, there is no restriction for prepayment of loan and withdrawal of deposit for customer. So, that is our option. But if this word is not given, then it is gap or mismatch risk. Sanctioned a term loan. Term loan is for 7 years. And deposit funding is done from a deposit. Deposit is for 3 years. So definitely there will be some gap. So gap or mismatch is the right answer. If this word is not given, there is no restriction for prepayment of loan and withdrawal of deposit. The word is here. So this is embedded option risk. Embedded option risk arises whenever there is prepayment of loan or withdrawal deposit for customer. Thank you for watching this video, friends, and kindly subscribe to our channel.